Boat Safety Scheme. Well, you can get the checklist for this. You can download it as a PDF, and it's called the B.S.S. Checklist for Privately Owned and Managed Vessels. Here are the first couple of pages. There's a total of 7 pages if you want to download it and read it all. And this is why, or one of the reasons why, I came to Birmingham was to get my boat safety scheme certificate done, or basically known as the boat safety certificate by most people. I needed a couple of jobs done because I'd gone through this checklist and I thought my boat might be a little bit on the iffy side. It just really depended possibly with the examiner. But there was a couple of things. Well, was it, you know, it'd been on the boat long enough, it was all grandfathered in, or would it need replacing? So, in most circumstances, I've made the replacements, except for one, which was impossible to do. Anyway, that's what this video is about. A couple of little jobs I've done on the boat which weren't boat safety certificate orientated, but a couple of jobs that were done on the boat to help it go through, of course. So let's get on with the video, let's see what we've done and see if the boat passes. Let's hold our breath, cross our fingers, and hope we get the right results at the end of it. Sorry about the light in this, but if I turn the light off, you won't be able to see it. This is a little job I've done myself. Now, I had a hole up here where I'd cut out the roof panel so that the chimney could go up through, and it was, I'd been think of a way of actually trying to fix it for a while. This board here, this new board in here, actually came out of the back of a wardrobe that my parents gave me, and some old trim bits here which I took something else apart, and a little bit of a fill-in here and up here. It's not with the proper pine board, it's some board I found from a different job. So it's a bit of a put together, an aluminium plate here, going around the chimney. That was actually a mortar board for a plasterer's mortar board. I will change these screws over. I'm gonna get some domed headed covers screws to put on here, but they're just they're temporary at the moment until I get to the hardware store and get the screws I want to actually put in there. I do need to do a little bit of a sand off and take some of these lumps off here and just finish it off, but otherwise it looks an awful lot better than it did when I had a big hole in the ceiling. I also painted the back panel there in the fireproof grey paint. I'm not over keen on the colour of it. It's coming out a little brighter on here, lighter than it actually is. I would like a slightly lighter paint to match in with my grey tiles a little bit better. But that's what I had, so it's what got used. So that was a job that I've done myself. Now for a couple of jobs that I actually got somebody else to do for me. And see the blue Arctic cabling here? Well, when the inverter was put in, when I put the inverter in, most of the wiring was linked up to some of the original, which was twin plus earth, which is frowned upon, although it was original from the boat and technically you can have it. I've actually had a lot of it changed, so you can't see it because of course it's all behind the sockets now, which are all running in behind the wall, so you can't actually see the new wiring. Just about seeing here, all the electrics have been marked up nicely. The new bus bars, which I had put on a while ago, all now been tidied up a bit. And yes, all the electrics in here. it's looking quite good. Nice and neat and tidy. And there you can see the blue cables coming through. Another little job I had done was the bilge pump rewired. I changed the bilge pump a while ago and the wires were not exactly routed very nicely, so I had them rerouted all nice and tidily around the bulkhead and round to the bilge pump, so they don't now just go straight across the engine bay. So that was another little job I had done as well, although that I don't think would have been a failure on the safety certificate anyway, but it was just a little job while I was having some electrics done I had also done. So on to the safety certificate. The examiner turned up to check my boat. He went through all the normal things. I had gone through and looked at these things in advance, a couple of things I couldn't check, so I wasn't too sure on. Number one, of course, safety on a boat is the gas. And he puts on his little bubble tester or whatever it's called, and it's in the kitchen. By turning off the gas at the bottle is to see if the pressure stays, so there's no leakage, I believe is how it works. It's which he connected up and it stabilized. I think it is for 5-10 minutes or whatever, and the pressure stays nice and stable, so the gas passed. Of course, the other things on the gas also, check out in the gas locker that the gas cylinders are secure and they can't move around, and that all the piping is of the right type and all secured to the bulkhead with adequate numbers of fixings, which obviously was all good as well. From there onwards, of course, they check the AC and the DC, the bolt, you know, the power was okay, nothing dangerous, nothing hanging out or whatever. So that was all good. My AC from the inverter is all good. That all passed okay. And the DC also was good. And that passed okay. Other things then was the fire, because it has to check the fire. Not smoke blowing into the cabin or whatever, so that's all checked out. There's no leaks and that the chimney height's correct and the fire's drawn up and out of the way, which all passed no problem at all. We also checked obviously things like the smoke alarms and carbon monoxide detectors. I believe you only actually need one carbon monoxide detector on the boat. I have two. And I believe for a boat this length, it's recommended to have two fire alarms. But I have two smoke detectors, I should say, and I have three. So that was good news, no problem at all. They all work. The other thing then, of course, to do a fire, you need to have three fire extinguishers on the boat. And if you have like a gas cooking stove like I have, you also need a fire blanket. There you can see is my fire blanket. And I also have three powder fire extinguishers. One which is up near the fire, one in the kitchen, and one in the back cabin, where the engine is, of course, towards the back there. And they have to be powder these days on a boat. I think the reason for that is that they're much more difficult to misuse than say a water fire extinguisher or some of the other ones like the chemical ones or a foam one, which you need to make sure you're using on the correct fires and the direction of spray must be very accurate, where the powder ones are a little bit more forgiving. Although when I did fire extinguisher training years ago, it was always suggested that they're probably more dangerous to have in a building or in a place than not to have, because you shouldn't really attempt to tackle the blaze yourself normally. What you should do is evacuate the building, or the boat in this case, as quickly as possible, and call the local authorities to deal with it. That is the safest way to deal with any fire. So although I have fire extinguishers, because one has to for the safety certificate, personally I think they can be more dangerous than good. Although, as I say, these are powder ones, so they can be used on just about all fires. So that's basically the main things which are checked on your safety certificate for your boat. There are a few odds and ends checked as well, but those are the main items. And yes, my boat passed, and here is the safety certificate. You can see on there, it tells you various things basically which are on the boat, which have been checked. Whether, if you have them, obviously if you don't have them, they can't be checked. So my boat has a safety certificate, all good to go again for another 4 years, which is nice to know. Now everything's all finished on the boat, I am ready to leave Birmingham. The only problem is the direction I want to go, the locks are closed until the 18th of March. So by the time you see this video, it's going to be about another week or so before I leave here. And I'm going to head off back, well, I guess it's up the Birmingham and Faisley Canal, I guess it's we called up. It's going north-ish. Anyway, I'm going to head back towards Faisley Junction and back up towards the Trent and Mersey. At this moment in time anyway, that's assuming the locks all open as I need them to. So, we'll be back to cruising very shortly. I much prefer to make cruising videos than this type of video myself. Although I think they're more difficult to make. You know, you're outside in the elements. You're dealing with wind and trying to hold a camera on a moving boat and everything. Much more difficult to film. But personally, I much prefer to do it. I love being outside anyway. And I love cruising. And I love bringing my cruising videos to you. So that's going to sort of bring me to the end of this video. What I really must do is thank, of course, all my Patreon and PayPal supporters. Your donations have just gone towards paying for my boat safety certificate. Your help for this is extremely and very gratefully received, because otherwise I really would have been struggling to have paid for my boat safety certificate with the way all the costs are going up, fuel costs, etc. A bottle of gas now is just gone up by about 30% in the last week. So yes, thank you very much indeed to everybody that supports the channel, and to everybody for watching, of course, because by watching you are also supporting the channel. You know, the ads I know are annoying on the videos. I don't like the ads either, but you got to realize that £20-25 a month I make on advertising through YouTube does help a lot to keep the channel going, even if it's just replacing worn out SD cards and things like that. You know, everything costs money and I really just don't have any of it. So every little penny I can earn, like people watching my videos and getting the few pennies for every video I make, you know, most of my videos make £2-3, so I don't make a lot of money on them, but those £2-3 go to great use for me keep bringing you these videos. So if you're not subscribed, please do subscribe. Have that old subscriber count go up, because that way it does help in YouTube determining it's recommending my content to you, of course, as a subscriber, and to other people, which in course will hopefully help grow the channel into being a bigger channel. And the more subscribers, the more viewers I get, the more pennies I can make from advertising on the channel. As I say, it's not the main reason for the channel being there, but without that little bit of advertising revenue, it would be very, very hard to keep the channel going, because I just wouldn't be able to afford to buy things like new SD cards. Well, that is definitely going to bring me to the end of this video. Don't forget, if you're not already subscribed, please subscribe, and don't forget to hit that old bell notification button. That way YouTube will inform you every time I upload a new video. And that just leaves me to say, thank you very much for watching. Trevor out.